With pretrial motions getting underway, the state of Florida is going to officially begin testing its case against Theodore Robert Bundy. Defendant described by some Miami residents as crazed and warped, by others as cool-headed and engaging. The jury of his peers selected by Mr. Bundy is a diversified lot.
I think we have a jury.
Swear the jury, Madam Clerk.
All
jurors, please stand. Raise your right hand.
The jury is predominantly male, predominantly black, and has convinced the defense of a collective lack of knowledge about the case. Rudolph Trimmel, in the glasses in the back row, is a senior project engineer for Texaco. He moved to South Florida just a short time ago and is the likely choice for jury foreman. Trimmel reads the Wall Street Journal, plays tennis, and is a political independent. Ted Bundy is pleased with this jury.
I don't think anybody would say that jury is completely unbiased, but I think overall the jury is much less biased than what we would have seen in Tallahassee, and much better than what we hoped for in Miami, and he's pleased. It's not the perfect jury, but he's pleased.
Ruth Hamilton, in the glasses in the front row, is a maid at Homestead Air Force Base, is 61, and is in the habit of peering at Bundy over those thick glasses. Estelle Suarez, sitting next to her, is the only Latin on the jury, a bookkeeper with two children. She reads about grocery store prices when she reads the newspapers. Alan Smith, the man in the next seat, is an artist, the first juror selected. He has four children and says he's not clear in his mind about the death penalty. But Vernon Swindle, the black man sitting behind Smith, says he is for the death penalty.
To me, the issue of death penalty was not so terribly important as a person's ability, apparent ability to absorb a lot of information, a lot of detail, a person who had the personal strength to stick to that person's own evaluation or opinions, that sort of thing.
The remaining six jurors are comprised of two widows, a retired school principal, a school teacher, a grandfather, and a maintenance engineer. Emerging as the dominant figure in this trial is the judge, Edward Cowart, who is proving that he has a commitment to a fair judicial proceeding, and he has a sense of humor. But he's been stern with the media, at times impatient with all the lawyers. He should maintain his tight control over this trial, as he has shown today. Ruth Walsh, in Miami, for News 4.